goes ay 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 ay. Forget the other guys. You'll never fall. This time you go. Hold tight, hold tight, hold tight, ay 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 ay. Hold tight, make me feel what you say is for real. And yeah, hold tight, carousel, yeah, girl, you're yeah, ring yeah, my yeah, bell. And yeah, hold tight, cable fly, swing it low, swing it high, ay 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 ay. We're gonna make the sky. You'll never fall. It's time you fall. Oh, giant. Oh, giant. Oh, giant. Oh, giant. Hold tight, count of three. Gotta stay close by me. And hold tight, check and check.
Why did they invite you?
Well, that's rather an embarrassing question to ask. Presumably they liked the shape of my nose, or they'd heard something of my reputation.
Forget the other guys. You'll never fall. It's time you go. Hold tight. Oh,
the guy whose feet are too big for his bed. Nothing seems to fit. Those raindrops are falling on my head. They keep falling. So I just did me some talking to the sun. And I said I didn't like the way he got things done. Sleeping on the job. Are falling on my head, they keep falling. But there's one thing I know, the blues they send to meet me won't defeat me. It won't be long till happiness steps up to greet me. Raindrops keep falling on my head, but that doesn't mean my eyes will soon be turning red. Crying's not for me, 'cause I'm never gonna stop the rain by complaining, because I'm free. Nothing's worrying me. Steps up to greet me. A raindrops keep falling on my head, but that doesn't mean my eyes will soon be turning red. Crying's not for me, 'cause I'm never gonna stop the rain by complaining, because I'm free. Nothing's worrying me.
Radford in the 6-yard area, and Armstrong with the kick. McClintock to Kelly. Made a little space for himself there, Kelly. And a bit more there as well. They go! By Kelly! But Jeff Trafford is standing! George Graham. To Bob McNabb right up. Can he turn it back? A good cross there from McNabb!
Jennifer Luff of Walton-on-Thames, Surrey. Could you tell me, please, if Bob McNabb has a fan club? And if so, how I can get
yes,
in touch
with him? Yes,
it's three of them here.
No, I haven't, Brian.
You haven't.
Oh,
just Malcolm Allison.
It's like a shadow kind of movie. And when the music fades,
the Queen has asked me to form the next government. And I am indeed proud to accept.
It's like a shadow kind of movie. And when the music starts, oh, I know that you and I are the lovers who end with broken hearts. Heaven knows I tried so hard. Just when I feel I'm free, some nostalgic moment comes to remind me how everything used to be. It's only love, but it won't let me go.
from your window over there that your family are keen Arsenal supporters. What do you feel about the arrival of the football season?
I dread it.
Why?
Well, I dread it for the crowds, but I'm glad of it to get rid of my own mob. Let's put it that way. And also, it's so convenient to see living here. Everybody calls in for a cup of tea and a sandwich before they go to the match, and another cup of tea and a sandwich when they come out of the match. That's the part I dread, but I'm glad to get rid of my two boys and my husband over there.
Well, I look forward to it. We all go, actually, and summer seems quite dull when there's no football on.
So you're not a football widow?
You don't? No, we all go.
How about you? Is it the same with you?
Yes, well, I go to all the home matches and the away ones, and I try to go abroad as well if I can.
So you've got no regrets about the coming football season at all?
No. I look forward to it.
Well, my husband dashes home from work, has a quick snack, and he's over there in no time. And the two boys are gone on, and one of the boys would travel to the end of the world. I think he'd follow Arsenal anywhere.
No, I don't think anything. I think that's right. It's a man's sport, isn't it?
You don't think that the women are neglected?
No, of course not. It's only what they make of it, isn't it, really?
The old ones don't mind, it's the young ones. The old ones don't mind, glad to get rid of them for half hour. It's the dolly birds that want to man them all the time.
So you've got no complaints?
No, why should I?
How about you? Can I ask you now, what do you think about the football season starting?
Well, I think it's a good sport for the chaps and get them out of the way.
And you don't think that a lot of women are just left in a situation where they're neglected by their husbands?
No, they're glad to get them out of the way, believe me.
On by Kelly. And the goal by John Radford. Just a very simple little side put, or he made it look simple, from the pass by Kelly. Story has moved to the inside right position. Armstrong in the middle. Radford on his own. Stepney and Sadler have every right to say, why did you leave this man completely unmarked? Two goals in 4 minutes for Arsenal, and John Radford gets them both. Graham, Rice, Graham, Story, Kennedy going in, Radford! Radford, his third goal after 15 minutes of the second half, and what a start to Arsenal's home season. Kennedy, Radford, then he got Kennedy up with him, Armstrong behind him. Graham going in. Bob Wilson, I just had a glance at. Very happy, as is George Graham.
The largest ever held in Europe. And when you said that, you've just about said the lot. Hell's Angels were there, gathering strength for a spot of aggro, but apart from the more lunatic fringe, this vast crowd had come with peaceful intent. There were rumours of the promoters ending up in the red, and other indications that the days of the giant festival are numbered. Critics talk about this generation being antisocial. But I can't remember a time when so many people got together in such harmony for the simple pleasure of laying around and listening to their kind of music.
Well, Story. To Hinton. And now Harris. Hollins has gone off on another break and Nelson's gone with him. Hollins! Good work by Hollins! Oh, against the post! Can he do it? He can! John Hollins! Oh, what a beautiful goal! That is what you call an individual goal! Kennedy swooping to get to that one. Armstrong to Nelson. No, still in play, says the linesman. So it's George Armstrong. Kennedy looking for this one as well. And number four, Kelly, over the line. Oh, a goal by Kelly. Out of the blue. Still 1-1. Osgood. Mulligan in a lot of space down the right. And a good pass there from Osgood to Mulligan.
Succeed at last. Yeah. Persecution, you must be. Win or lose, you gotta get your sheep. You got your mind set on a dream.
Kelly, or he sent a letter. That's a good ball from Graham. He's got three on the far post, one coming across the nearest Kennedy.
To me. Oh, I despise costing me destruction of innocent lives. War means tears to thousands of mothers die when their sons go up to fight and lose their lives. I said war. Good God, y'all.
What is it good for?
Absolutely. Nothing. Get sad again.
War.
To me.
Whoa.
It ain't nothing but a heartbreak.
Whoa.
Send only to the undertaker.
We were coming out in different stages and I seen Peter Marinella getting thrown across a taxi and I seen somebody else and anyway we jumped him and I grabbed one guy and somebody jumped in my back and was punching me in the back of the head, but I wouldn't let this fella go. And we had a fella called Jackie Carmichael, who was a Scots guy, he was in our team, and he had somebody pinched against the wall and he was battering the hell out of him. But it was total mayhem and it lasted for about 10 minutes.
The Jimi Hendrix experience is over. The acid rock musician died today in a London hospital, apparently from an overdose of drugs.
Young and impatient.
Kennedy. Armstrong. This is picked up by Burrows. Green not in almost the right position. Roberts having to clear very quickly indeed. This is Dobing. Good ball. Greenoff. The Conroy. Looking for Ritchie again. Ritchie there. And it's a goal. That was a very well taken goal indeed. Big John Ritchie scores his sixth goal of the season and puts Stoke City one goal ahead. The Arsenal defence was stuck there and Ritchie really rose to it. A very, very good goal. And Ritchie, one man and another. Now Ritchie in with a chance, Ritchie with a shot, and what a great goal by John Ritchie! What an absolutely great goal! The Arsenal defence was staggered by the fact he fought for that ball. John Ritchie scores his seventh league goal of the season, and he did it all by himself. Greenoff, Dobing, Conroy, Marsh cutting down that right wing. Good 1-2, and a good shot, and what a goal! What a goal! What a great 1-2 that was, and Terry Conroy put that ball past Bob Wilson, he didn't even see it. 3-0 for Stoke City, and what a beautiful play that was. This is Conroy again. Marsh is absolutely steaming down that right wing. That's a good ball, come to Greenhoff. And the bounce of the ball is there, Greenhoff with a chance. It's a chip, and it's in the net! A great goal by Greenhoff! How beautifully he played that, he just waited for it. Arsenal's defence again in tatters, but the goal from Greenhoff, he just waited, he picked his spot, and he put it in the far side of that net. And my goodness now, that crowd are going delirious. Stoke City 4, Arsenal 0, and those are four of the best goals we've seen for a long time. Bob Wilson must be wondering what has hit him today. And his shot blocked, again by Smith. This is Harry Burrows, only three men up at the moment, but Marsh going down that right wing, and there he goes. Marsh is cutting in very fast, Ritchie with him. Marsh with a shot, with one save, there's another goal! Makes it 5-0 for Stoke City.
Roberts, the big Arsenal defenders, crept up to the edge of the 18-yard line. Armstrong, Graham, Kennedy! Kendall going with Kennedy. It's going to be a free kick to Arsenal. Rice. Perfectly taken. taken by Kennedy. John Roberts. Kendall. Graham for Arsenal. The kick's been given. Again, another problem for... No, he's given the throw. So another problem if it had been a high ball, but Radford with the throw. And he can throw a long one too. Kelly! Better. He took it supremely well. Don Howe, this talented Arsenal coach, must be so well pleased. Kennedy, Kelly. Armstrong, Story. Totally unnecessary, but clear cut. An innocuous situation. But the ball was handled. Peter Story placing it for the penalty.
Studio guest today is George Armstrong of Arsenal, probably having his best spell since he joined the club, and he'll be talking to Jimmy Hill. But now it's time for the action and the first visit of the big match this season to Highbury. Arsenal against Derby County, and while Arsenal have consolidated their good form of last season, Derby have slipped badly, and here they face a task as formidable as any in the First Division. Because Arsenal, unbeaten at home, again field a settled side, a side in which Ray Kennedy, with 12 goals, has taken so much of the glory. But alongside Kennedy and forming a dangerous spearhead for the Arsenal this season is John Radford. Here's Radford, whose form has never been better. As for Derby County, they've been plagued by injury, and Terry Hennessy here has had more than his share. Now most of those injuries have cleared up, and one man who will have his work cut out today is Roy McFarlane, their young number five. In the Highbury crowd, Scottish team manager Bobby Brown on the left with Wally Barnes. He'll be watching men like O'Hare, Kelly and Graham.
It seems that the shouting match on the terrace has got a little more warmth and passion to it than the match on the pitch itself. But here's Radford. And a break by Armstrong, and McFarlane getting there first, and Kelly going in! Kelly! Oh, great piece of opportunism by Eddie Kelly! The pace of Kelly really made that one as he pounced on that pass back, took it round Les Green and quickly found the back of that Derby County net to put Arsenal ahead. And Armstrong with Derby claiming that he was offside, but the linesman keeping his flag down. Armstrong still going on and just failing to poke that one through by the near post.
While Derby were waiting and half appealing, Armstrong was going on, and three men converging on him just to prevent him scoring. Rice. Armstrong. I think Arsenal's best chance at the moment is to play as strongly as possible on Armstrong, who seems to have the pace and the skill to take on his fullback and beat him. Here's Armstrong again, beating him once more, and almost getting that across, and certainly getting a corner as two men came in quickly, Mackay and Gemmell. But Armstrong seems the best possible way for Arsenal to find a way through this Derby defence at the moment. Roberts again gone to that near post. There's the corner. Roberts looking for it. And Kennedy couldn't quite turn it back. But my goodness! With Green at one side of his goal, Graham very nearly turned that over his shoulder and dribbled it in by the near post. Mackay getting it away off the line. That's for O'Hare. Oh, McClintock going on. And McClintock with a shot that's wide. Well, we used to see a lot of that sort of thing from McClintock when he was a midfield player. But that's the first time I've seen him go forward into a shooting position for Arsenal this season. Arsenal's throw. George Graham. That's aimed towards Radford. Up he goes! Oh, Radford! My goodness, what a leap! Beautifully timed there. The cross from Graham, and Radford leaping superbly to time it and head it into that Derby net for number two. Rice back to Wilson, and now it has come to Armstrong. Beating Dermot, a little flick there wide of Hector, beautiful play. This is much better now from Arsenal. McNabb, Radford, McNabb. Turn there under that crossbar and pushed away by Green. Oh, a really brilliant move there by Arsenal. Begun as so many things this afternoon have been begun by George Armstrong, the number seven. Hinton to take it. O'Hare waiting, Hennessy making a burst as well. McFarlane is right there being barged off the ball, in fact. But still getting it across, McClintock away, and Gemmell with a shot, saved there instinctively, I think, by Wilson, but saved nonetheless. And now Hinton turning it in again, and pushed away by Peter Story.
Now let's meet our guest, George Armstrong, and let me tell you first of all how he came to be our guest. We went into the Arsenal dressing room at the end of the match yesterday and asked the players who they would most like to see from their team on the programme today. Unanimously, they plumped for George Armstrong, saying his form over the last couple of months has been fabulous. Here's George with Jimmy Hill.
Well, George, that's praise indeed from your own teammates.
To thank the lads myself on Monday, I think.
You won't share the fee with them, will you?
No, not at all, no.
George, how long have you been at Arsenal?
Well, this is my 10th season now, Jimmy.
And how do you feel the club has progressed in that time? I mean, are Arsenal as great now, as good as they've ever been?
Well, in that time I've certainly seen good individuals, but this team at the present time is the best I've played in.
What is there about the team that makes it extra special?
Well, just the spirit in the team. Everybody's fighting for one another. And that's about it, you know, they've got faith in each other. And there's a lot of skill in the team, actually, as well.
I'm glad you mentioned that, because some Arsenal fans feel that there still isn't enough skill in the middle of the field. Do you think there is skill there?
Well, I suppose every team's got room for improvement, but at the moment I can't see anybody getting our team at the moment, you know.
What about your passing movements? Do you think you're building those gradually? They're getting better as time goes on?
We can pass as good as anybody on the day. It just depends on which defence lets you do it. Yeah. Derby, I thought, in the first 35 minutes yesterday played great, especially Dave Mackay.
But what about when you got your confidence? Your passing then improved, do you think?
Yeah, so I've never thought we were a bad, you know, team for passing. You know, we've always been very good at it. In fact, George Graham and myself and Bob McNabb, we have got such a good understanding that just like clockwork now, really.
You talk about when you were a young boy. What about the young boys in the Arsenal team now? Do you see them great futures for them?
Oh, great players. Ray Kennedy, Eddie Kelly, Charlie George is injured, but all these lads are great players. Pat Rice even are playing at fullbacks having a great season.
And John Roberts, who's made immense progress over here.
Well, John, I think he surprised really everybody. You know, he's playing tremendous. I've never seen a centre forward have a good game against him yet. Yeah. And he's played against some of the probably the best in the country at the moment. You know.
Well, I think, George, you must take, along with the other Arsenal experienced players, Frank McClintock and the others, credit for helping them improve alongside you.
Well, this is it, Jim. You know, you've got to have faith in everybody. And Frank especially has given the lads some encouragement. In fact, all the experienced players have been mulling around the young ones and have done great with them.
George, thank you very much indeed. I wish you another 10 years in football.
Tambling, Sewell trying to lift it in under that crossbar, and a goal! Oh, what a mistake by Sprake, and Sewell has equalised! Oh, and Sprake furious with himself! It's a shame the way you hurt me. It's a shame the way you mess around with your man. I'm sitting all alone by the telephone waiting for your call when you don't call at all. It's a shame the way you mess around with your man. It's a shame the way you play with my emotions. It's a shame the way you mess around with your man. You're like a child at play on a sunny day. First you play with love and then you throw it away.
Why do you use me? Try to confuse me. How can you stand to be so cruel?
You mess around with your man. It's a shame the way you hurt me. It's a shame the way you mess around with your man. I tried to speak with you, show your love so true, but you won't appreciate the love we try to make. Oh, it's a got to be a shame.
Your guest today, Frank McClintock, the skipper who's done so much to inspire Arsenal this season. But now the action from Highbury yesterday. Arsenal against Liverpool, a vital First Division match because both are pacemakers on the table, both desperate now for victory to keep in touch with Leeds at the very top. And today, undoubtedly, it'll be a stern challenge for Arsenal, but at least they have John Samuels back in their side, his first home appearance after a bad ankle injury, skillful attacker, powerful shot, and at the other end of the Arsenal side, a return to Highbury for the number six, Peter Simpson. This after a cartilage operation, now he takes his familiar place in the back four. Arsenal have a good record against Merseyside this season with 3 points out of four against Everton. But Liverpool now come here with John Toshek, their new £110,000 signing from Cardiff City, a real threat in the air for the Arsenal defence. Toshek who scored in his first game against Everton last week.
Simpson. Must give Arsenal a lot of reassurance to see Simpson back in their back four. Rice and Armstrong just getting a boot to it. And there do seem to be these moments of extreme hesitancy in this Liverpool defence. It's Kennedy putting it back now for Samuels. A chance to turn it in left-footed, far side, McNabb. Lawler beating him away, and that's going to be a free kick with the linesman's flag going on the far side. The referee's whistle as well. And a free kick to Arsenal. Lloyd a little bit shaky there in his own six-yard area, which is dangerous. Lawler impeding McNabb on the far side, and that's why we get this free kick. And that wall surely has got to move back a little further, but just chipped in there. And Lloyd not getting it away. Story bursting through. And a ricochet off the Liverpool defence. Story really caught it. A man who scored only two goals this season, and both of them for a penalty. Very nearly putting Arsenal into the lead, but getting a corner for them. With coming up to 8 minutes gone, George Armstrong with it. Under that Liverpool crossbar again, coming towards Samuels, first time on the volley, down for Clements. McLaughlin, Hughes, surging forward to look for Highway, nodded in nicely there towards Toshack. Highway again, challenged by Simpson. Fair acceleration, Highway's got to the far side! Oh, and how did that one go in? Three men finished up in the net, and somehow the ball escaped it. McClintock, Radford, Story trying to push his way through, Kennedy now for John Samuels! He really is in the mood for it this afternoon, Samuels. Simpson for Arsenal, Armstrong, Rom ahead of him, McNabb outside him, Armstrong going in, challenged though by McLaughlin, it's still Armstrong going in, and Clements at full stretch to come out and gather that one. A real lovely little snaky run by George Armstrong. McNabb with the throw. Oh, that was too casual a pass by Story, and Highway is really away. Oh, good work by Wilson. A really great smother save by Bob Wilson. Tremendous run by Steve Highway there. Ross. Oh, and now Graham. Picked off for Samuels. Graham! Oh, a fine goal! George Graham! And what a goal it was! That was unstoppable! A magnificent 1-2. And Graham on the volley, giving Clements no chance. By Graham, and he's picked on for Kennedy. Oh, and surely he will score. Radford! After Kennedy made such a meal of it, with Liverpool claiming offside. And Radford, who finally put it in, when it seemed that Kennedy had lost the chance and Lloyd might have got it away. So 2-0. Rice. And now George Graham just over. And in fact, whether that would have counted had it gone in or not, I don't know, because the whistle has certainly gone now. At what point it went, I don't know, but there's no doubt that George Graham scored the first goal for Arsenal to put them into the lead, with a second goal coming from John Radford to keep Arsenal's unbeaten home record, to put them just to his Radford, who scored that second one, to keep them well in touch still with Leeds United at the top of the table. And so the final score here at Highbury, Arsenal 2, Liverpool 0.
A good solid performance there by Arsenal, I thought, although I noticed this morning that Bill Shankly, the Liverpool manager, said that he thought that both the Arsenal goals were offside. That's something we must investigate now with the Arsenal skipper, Frank McClintock, and with Frank, of course, Jimmy Hill.
Well, in fact, what Bill Shankly says, Frank, I think you'll agree, is always entertaining, but it's not always accurate, as we'll see later on. But I want to ask you, first of all, about the Liverpool side. What about their challenge?
A very strong team. It surprised me, actually, because they've changed their team quite dramatically from last season, Jimmy. They've got people like Ronnie Yates and Ian St. John and Tommy Lawrence out, and I'm surprised they're doing so well. But evidently, they must have found some good players, the centre-half and the highway, and they seem to have settled into a very difficult side to beat.
Yeah. Well, I think we've talked enough about Liverpool now. What about this lovely London side, Arsenal, at the moment, second in the league, and the golden goal yesterday?
Well, we're not playing just as well as we were, say, 3 or 4 weeks ago. But if you're going to try and win a championship or challenge for a championship, you'll have sticky spells, and sometimes you'll be a little bit lucky, and other times you'll probably be unlucky. Like I thought we were a few weeks ago against Crystal Palace. I thought we played well enough to win, and we didn't get the result, and we were a little bit disappointed. But
yesterday you didn't get the goal early on against this defence, mm-hmm. but of course when you did get it, Bill Shankly said it was offside. Mm. We can now look and see exactly how it came about.
Well, the Arsenal forwards here do a lot of challenging here, putting the defence under pressure. I think that's John Samuels, just wins the ball there to George Graham. George draws the man in, plays it to John Samuels, and a beautiful chip over his head. And you can see George is well onside, and he connects with a beautiful volley. And there's no chance of that ball being offside there, Jimmy, I don't think. No chance at all.
It's indicative, really, of the Arsenal method, the way in which you put defences under pressure to win the ball.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think sometimes the supporters really understand this, because they look upon you as a hard, grinding side, uh-huh. but you have to win it before you can play that kind of football.
Of course you do, and it's very difficult to keep this sort of tackles in. You know, if you're diving from one player to another, you have to get it done collectively by your forwards, or else you'll just get shattered after 20 minutes. And you can see just from that goal there, there was about three players involved there. There was Peter Storey, John Samuels and George Graham, and eventually we won the ball, a good 1-2, and it finished up with a goal. Mm.
The last one came from your own half of the field, the second goal, actually.
Yes.
A good goal, well worked?
Yes, I thought so. I thought there was a suspicion of it being offside, but after watching it, I don't think it was. George Armstrong just plays the ball in here. It's controlled well.
There's
by
George
Graham's
header.
You
can see that just on the edge of the frame of your picture, you can see there Kennedy, who is outside the 10-yard circle there and onside.
I think there's about a yard onside there, Jimmy, myself.
Look how well he beats the goalkeeper here on a sixpence. A lot of people blamed him for missing that goal, but I don't think they realised the difficulties he was under, because there was Lloyd watching him.
Mm-hmm.
Now, while Lloyd's watching the ball, Radford catches him out the same way.
Yes.
So that Kennedy was beating the goalkeeper and watching him and lost the ball. Lloyd got it. Then he was so busy watching the ball that he lost Radford, and that was the end of it. I feel that Arsenal's problems at the moment are that you can't find your best team. You've got so many good players, mm-hmm. Frank, that wouldn't like to pick the best Arsenal 11 at the moment, and I think Bertie Mee's got a difficult job. Do you think that can be a disadvantage?
Not in the long run, I don't think, Jim. It can be until eventually they find the perfect blend, which must be there, I think. And it may just happen by accident. Maybe somebody gets injured and another player will come in, and it just might be the perfect blend.
I think one of the problems is that with young players in the side, like Kelly and Kennedy and things like that, they can't, because they've not been in the game that long, they can't produce consistent form. The crowd, I think, in view of what he's done, were a bit short-tempered with Kennedy yesterday. What do you think of him as a prospect?
I think he's a great player. For a defender, he's a wonderful man to find. If you ever look and you're struggling to find any player, Ray's always showing for the ball, shields the ball very well and lays it off. He's only 19, he's only been a professional, I think, about a year and a half. And I think he's going to get better and better. I think he's going to be one of the best centre-forwards in the country.
Well, it looks as if the best of Arsenal is yet to come.
I hope so, yes, I think so, Jim.
Frank McClintock going to be there then too?
Oh, I hope so, Jim. Getting on a bit now.
Like a bird in the sky, was riding all out like you were a bird. Flying all out like an eagle in a sunbeam, riding all out like you were a bird.
We're a tall hat, like the druid in the old days. We're a tall hat and a tattooed gal. Ride a white swan that the people of a Beltane. Where you headlong, babe, you can't go wrong. Catch a bright star in a place you know, your forehead. Say a few spells and baby, there you go. Take a black cat and a sip it on your shoulder, and in the morning you'll know all you in the old days. Wear a tall hat and a tattooed gown. Ride a white swan like the people of the Beltane. Where you headlong, babe, you can't go wrong.
To Radford. Armstrong, Graham, it's Wilson now to Munro. Oof! And the weapon was Sal's, that Story. Story for Arsenal. Sparkin. Rice. Radford. McCallie was looking for Parks and he didn't hit it properly. The corner. The Wolves' defence, which has been under such pressure in the first half, in the air from players like Radford, number 11, Graham. Conceded 37 goals this season, so they've clearly suffered a little bit for their gambling and trying to score goals. Oh, Samuels, and that flick from Kennedy nearly bled off. Redford, 2-0!
When I met you, you were too young to hang around where the hippies hung, the swing and dance where the swingers swung. Well, you're ready now, you're ready now, you're ready now, girl, you're ready now. You grew up fast, like overnight. You have changed, girl, you're out of sight. You wanna swing and dance all night. You're ready now, you're ready now, you're ready. You move and groove just the way you should. You got that feel, you're running good. When you're ready now, oh, you're ready now. You're ready now, girl, you're ready now.
Bam, Radford, Graham, and a goal scored by McClintock. Who brought the ball back in defence, put them all back up in attack. Fitzpatrick, the little fellow on the goal line. Oh, another lovely header by Graham. 2-0. Two corners, two goals. Rice, Kennedy, and it's 3-0.
give a smile to the viewers. They're a lovely smile. And now ask the question.
Who do you think are the main challenges for the league?
And Leeds are in a very, very good position, but I think Arsenal will probably win the title this year, the way they're playing. I know it may be the wrong thing to say back home, folks, but they look very good to me, Arsenal, this year, actually. They played very well against Tottenham, and they look a very good bet, I think, to challenge Leeds for the title.